meet someone who can shed a bit more light on the subject. Yes. Our first guest tonight was born in Adelaide,
Snowtown Killer.
No, he wasn't a Snowtown killer. He played for Coventry City in the Premier League before joining the Socceroos in 1997.
Charlie Yankos?
No, Charlie Yankos. He played in the 80s. Okay. He scored his first goal again.
Tiwi Islands.
No, well, close. It's Solomon Islands.
Okay.
In 2008, he was the highest paid Australian footballer in any of the four codes.
I'm going to go Charlie Yankos again.
No, this will do it. His penalty against Uruguay in the 2006 World Cup qualifier is ranked as one of the three greatest moments of Australian sporting history. Please welcome John Aloisi.
Yeah! Come on in.
And can I say, you're a bit Bresch-like in that pose out there.
Yeah, yeah, the chest out.
I thought I scored a goal after you said. You said about Messi scoring five goals. I scored five goals against Solomon Islands.
Yes.
I think Mark Bosnie scored five against Solomon Islands.
Was that your biggest... In the good old days, and we've spoken about this a lot, in the good old days of Oceania, when we used to teach American Samoa a lesson, what is the most amount of goals you ever smacked in?
No, it was only five. Archie got 13 against one team.
Because if you get a hat-trick, they give you the match ball. If you get 13, what do they give you, a house somewhere?
The balls around the ground.
Oh, you get all those.
John, we've heard a lot about the group of death, and I'm just thinking, if we were in the other group, they still would have called it the group of death. What do we know about the teams that we're up against in this final phase?
We know a lot. Of course, Japan, we know we played against them in the World Cup and also Asian Cup. Last Asian Cup in the final, they beat us. So we know them well and they know us well. Iraq, we played against them in the Olympics of 2004, and they beat us in the quarters. Also Asian Cup and last World Cup qualifiers, we played against them. So we know those two teams very well. Jordan, we don't know so much about, but they're going to be difficult. All those.
Do you have to say that? Are they shit? You can tell us.
Well, the Arab, the Middle Eastern countries, they play good football. They're technically very, very good if we allow them to play. If we don't allow them to play, then we should beat all of them.
His response to the group was, yes, I don't think there should be visa issues. I mean, what kind of response is that? It's like saying, you know, they've got good duty-free, so I think it's okay.
Do you get, like, where are the most hostile receptions? Like, where is it when you show up at the airport? I remember the classic footage when we showed up in Uruguay one time and they were sort of spitting and pelting stuff at the airport. Is it like that in some of the other, in the Middle Eastern countries and stuff like that as well?
No, not really. In Iran, when we played them back in 97, that was quite hostile. There was 127,000 people at the game.
Jeez.
And only men, because they didn't allow women to the stadium. Okay. So that was pretty scary and daunting. But most of the other countries are okay. I think Uruguay, if we can pass that test, then we should be all right in Asia.
Yes, absolutely.
But we played pretty well against Saudi Arabia. We're fairly confident that we should do okay in this phase, shouldn't we?
Well, the Saudis are probably better than most of the teams that we're going to play against.
Oh, that's what I want to hear.
Yeah, so beating them quite easy will hold us in good stead when we play Jordan, Oman, and those countries there.
Now, with you, Sammy?
Do you mind if I just switch for a second and just how are you enjoying your post-playing career, John?
I'm loving it.
What have you been doing?
I can eat and drink what I want. I don't have to worry about it.
I can see you've really let yourself go. Embarrassment.
No, I'm enjoying it. I've been coaching Melbourne Heart youth team and also helping out with the first team and enjoying the coaching side of things. Different to playing, but...
Speaking of the youth team, the Olyroos are possibly the next generation. We know that they haven't done very well. They haven't qualified for the Olympics. Do you think it's a problem?
Well, it's a problem when you don't score a goal, but not everyone sees what they had to go through. Aurelio Vidmar, the coach of the Olyroos, couldn't pick a full-strength squad at all. He couldn't pick overseas-based players because the clubs over there didn't allow him to. And so he was picking players that he was allowed to pick, so we didn't have the strongest of size.
It's like one of those skill tests, is it? Picking out, trying to get a toy out of there.
It was, and the pitch in Uzbekistan was basically ice, wasn't it, really?
Yeah, it was ice, and I didn't see the game, but a few of our players from Melbourne Heart played, and two goals were disallowed, and they said the refereeing wasn't great over there.
Yeah,
I don't know about that.
Yes, between you and me, Jeremy.
Now, you mentioned the Melbourne Heart. You're domestically, now your coach is leaving. You're a favourite to
you've got
take the job,
John. The qualifications you need to coach the Melbourne Heart. You're tanned and you're handsome.
I'm probably not as tanned as John Van Skier, but I'm getting there.
Are you up for it?
Well, if they asked me to, I'd love to coach the Melbourne Heart. You know, that would be a dream come true. A year out of the game and to get a top job like that. And the club itself is a great club.
Yeah,
and I think we've got a side that's performing well now, and it's only going to improve. So if I do get the job, it's not an easy task.
If you take the job, will you have to give up your ambassadorship with Head and Shoulders? that's a big one. I know that's like it's. I know. I was just looking at Santa then, and it reminded me to ask that question.
Just because I had flies buzzing around. What I did want to ask is, we haven't spoken about Clive Palmer for a couple of weeks, and I know that when people think of Clive Palmer, they, nutcase. That's what the immediate. Now, let's get beyond the nutcase side of it. Where there's smoke, there's sometimes fire. I mean, is there a problem with the FAA? I mean, I know he was a bit extreme, but is there something not quite right in the way the A-League is actually run?
Look, I left Australia to go play in Europe 20 years ago, and I played in the old NSL, which was the equivalent of the A-League. And you would have seen a lot of those games and the clubs around then. Mm-hmm. The game's improved so much, it's not funny. And of course, there's going to be teething problems in a new league, but the audiences are up on Fox, and also the crowds are up, even though Sam was...
Don't worry about it.
..was laughing at the crowd. But we're getting bigger crowds, and the football's improving. So the A-League is going well, and we're going to keep on improving.
The last thing I wanted to do was upset you.
Please thank John Aloisi. We'll be back after the break with another special guest. John, thanks so much for joining us.